Please show me the last minutes of my life. What will bring death to my house?
No, no, no! It can't be true! My own son!
Dear Royal Advisor, I'm obligated to report some unpleasant news to you. King Richard is seriously ill. The healers have tried their best to establish the real cause of his illness, but all their attempts have been fruitless. They say such an ailment may be the work of dark magic. The king insisted that you come. He knows about the Swamp Witch incident. That's why he believes you are the best inspector in the Magic Supervision Department.
Keep me abreast of his condition. I must be the first to know if he gets better or... Now, I have some business to attend to.
Hello, I'm Clarice, the King's healer. That was Andreas, the King's younger brother. I'm sorry he was so brusque with you, but who can blame him? I was looking forward to your arrival. I'm afraid the healers have exhausted their knowledge, and so have I. You are the King's last hope. Would you be so kind as to examine the King? If you learn anything new, please leave me a report of your findings.
I shouldn't have done that. My dear son.
Can you cover the mirror, please? It brings back the king's most painful memories. The king was going to celebrate his birthday. He was in a buoyant mood and even made some jokes. That day, Richard had a slight fever, nothing out of the ordinary, but then, just in a couple of hours, he came down with a high fever and started hallucinating. Neither the court's physician, nor any of our best Imperial healers, could identify the king's illness. They were all hopeless. None of them even noticed these horrible marks. They look terrible. I've never seen such marks before. Now it's clear why none of the medicine was helpful. Many years ago, Richard was very interested in his descendant's destiny. He knew that the magic mirror could show one's future. But Richard didn't like what he saw. His own son was going to betray him and usurp the throne. However, the king wasn't able to kill his child. Banishment was the only option. Someone wants to take advantage of the heir's apparent absence and usurp the throne. Andreas is the next legitimate claimant. Maybe he's the one who enchanted the king. In the Misty Forest, there is a dark magic expert who may be able to help Richard. Based on your report, I don't think we have another option. As you have already proven your competence and your loyalty to the crown, I think you should be the one to visit him. I'll stay here and take care of the king.
These monsters hate fire. Find something to scare it off. Thanks for the help. That was some quick thinking with that torch. I didn't have a chance to introduce myself. I'm Roald, an expert in the field of dark magic. I think I'm the one you've been looking for. I'll get to the bottom of this mystery regarding the king's poisoning. A special ritual will unveil the truth. But I'll need you to bring me some things first. I'll be waiting inside. Surprised you are here, asking for my help. I've been studying dark magic for a long time. Is there a chance that the inspector wants to see a folio on this subject? The book is right there, in my library. You can only see the letters with the help of this magic powder. Here.
Okay.
must arrest Andreas and get a hold of his spellbook. He'll use it to make poison. We'll use it to make an antidote and cure the king. The guards won't let us in, so we have to distract them and sneak in. Here, take this. It may be helpful. Wall. It looks brittle enough to blow up if we can find something explosive. That should distract the guards for long enough for us to get inside. It'll take them about 10 minutes to put out the fire. We have to act fast and find Andreas's spellbook. I'll go first. Follow me. This must be Andreas's study. We need to open the door. It says that Andreas hid the spellbook in his secret hideout and fled.
An intruder has gotten into the residence.
They're coming. We need to hide.
Nothing. This intruder is one step ahead of us. Well, let's search the area. He couldn't have gone far.
Andreas's hideout is on the Misty Island. The only way to get there is by boat. The faster, the better. The king will die if we don't get that spellbook. I'll go and have a look around. Here. Take this. You never know when it may come in handy.
Thank you.
People say these waters are extremely dangerous. The legend of this place chill folks to the bone. The road takes too long. We need to search Andreas's hideout and find this spellbook as fast as possible. Its tentacles are dragging us down. I have to get rid of them somehow. I can't hear your ideas, my friend. It's just a bit noisy over here. I couldn't have done it without your help. I'm afraid that Kraken will be back soon. Oh no! That monster made a hole in our boat! We have to fix it right away. Otherwise, we'll never see Misty Island. Now we can go. Damned monster slowed us down. We'd better hurry. The king's fading fast. Look! I bet that is what we were looking for. Andreas's hideout. The clock is ticking. We'd better split up and search the castle. One of us is sure to find the spellbook. Excellent. Now I know the antidote type. Let's go. We need to save the king.
King Richard is getting worse. Please, do something.
Do you recognize my face, Your Majesty? Or should I call you father? I'm your son, the one you banished from your own home. Today, I will have my revenge for all the years I've spent in exile. Plan worked. I conspired with Roald from the very beginning. I'll help him get revenge for his years in exile, and then we'll rule the kingdom together. And now, you and all of the king's confidence will be executed. It's nothing personal. Goodbye.
Hello, I'm Joseph. I was one of the king's closest advisors, and now I'm sentenced to death. Please, help me get rid of the shackles, and I'll help you get out of here. I can't fall asleep without my sleeping potion, so I always take it with me. If you pour it into the guard's glass, he'll fall asleep and we'll be able to run away. And take this, it'll be helpful.
Prisoners have escaped.
You should hide somewhere. I'll distract him.
Well, here's one. Let's take him to the square. We can't delay the execution anymore. And we have to find the second prisoner. I don't think he has gone far.
Thank you.
As your new king, I hereby decree that everyone in Richard's court shall be put to death. Executioner, come forward.
Hey, are you ready to execute the criminal? The crowd's waiting for you. Don't forget your axe, and take this.
It's the fugitives! Catch them!
Run, to the carriage, quick! Water is too deep for us to ford the river. I thank you for saving me, but we are still in danger. The guards will be here soon. We have to find a hideout and wait them out there.
Thank you. Find something to barricade the door. Quick!
Mm-hmm.
We're safe. Now we can have a rest. The guards must have left by now. I'll go and check. I won't be able to dress the wound without that medicine. Please, get my back back.
found my bag. Thank you. I'm sorry. I can't go further with you. I'm just a burden now. But I can dress this wound on my own, and I have relatives nearby who can hide me. I've long suspected that Andreas is a traitor. I thought that something was wrong when he didn't try to talk the king out of banishing his son. And now, I understand why. I suspect that everything that's happened these last few days is connected to that mirror somehow. You should meet Rain. She's the one who made it. She lives in Salzheim, right across the river. Good luck, and take this. I hope it'll help you.
Tell me everything you know about that charmed mirror. This is a direct order coming from Andreas himself.
I won't tell you anything, Clarice.
Thank you.
For helping me. I started taking orders for alchemical items when I'd just graduated from the academy. And one day, Andreas ordered a mirror that would predict the future. But I worry that he may have found a way to fake prophecies. I feel so guilty that I might be responsible for what is happening to the kingdom. I'll help you find the truth. We should sneak into the royal palace and learn what Andreas concealed. I know you're the chief inspector in the magic supervision department, but maybe you're interested in alchemy? You've brewed your first potion, so I invite you to visit my workshop. It's in the attic of my lab. Let's go and brew your unique potion! I'm sure there was a map. It's dangerous to go into the forest without it.
Thank you.
Andreas, I'm sorry. I didn't manage to find any information on the mirror.
Never mind, Clarice. I'll handle this later. And now, you are to prepare everything for the coronation. After I've finished things in my chambers, I'll join you.
Hello, I am Archibald, the caretaker of the Royal Crypt. It has been a long time since I had visitors. Even Richard hasn't come by here lately. And I guess in light of recent events, his next visit will be the last. If you're interested in the history of the royal family, I will be glad to let you in. The history of the royal family is shrouded in mystery. Only a few people know what was actually happening. The sad truth is hidden there in the royal crypt. I'll help you find it.
We must tie Andreas up as soon as possible, otherwise he'll attack us.
You won't be able to prove a thing!
We need to scour this room for any evidence that can prove Andreas faked the prophecy.
Thank you.
Andreas has charmed the mirror, using forbidden black magic to make Richard quarrel with his own son. It turns out that if Rald hadn't been banished, he would have gone against his father and killed him. Andreas never intended for Rald to actually become king. He soaked the crown with a poison. As soon as Rald puts the crown on his head, he'll drop dead.
Ha ha! The coronation has already started, and soon the new king will be dead. You won't prove a thing.
Oh, get to the main hall and stop the coronation. In the meantime, I'll be holding Andreas back. I won't let him escape.
It's time to begin the coronation. I'll officiate.
Blasted traitor! You'll pay for that!
Stop, all of you. I've just escaped from the dungeon where Roald was keeping me, but I'm here to defend my son.
Father, I only kept you imprisoned to make everybody think you were dead. I couldn't bring myself to kill you. Why are you standing up for me now?
You can't imagine how much I regret everything I've done to you. Banishing you was the biggest mistake of my life. I'm so sorry.
I forgive you, Father.
Oh, Rald, your father only banished you because his magic mirror told him that you would betray him. Oh, but that prophecy was faked. Andreas did it to get rid of the royal family and take the throne for himself. Ah, who knows what would have happened if the king hadn't summoned you.
I am eternally grateful to you. The entire kingdom owes you a great debt. As for Andreas, he'll rot in a prison cell forever.